from Arpan Basu, who says that an NHL source is telling The Athletic the Canadiens have informed their captain, Max Pacioretty, they will not negotiate a contract extension with him. And Billy, they go on to say in this article by The Athletic that Bergevin told Patches his intention is to trade him as soon as possible. What's your reaction to that?
That's blunt, straightforward. You're out. Thanks for everything. We do not want you in a Montreal Canadian uniform anymore. They want to say whatever they want in Montreal. It's full rebuild. Where do you go from here? With their players, if Max Pacioretty goes, they don't have any depth up front. They're small. They get Max Domi comes over. Jonathan Drouin is a forward that maybe can produce, but Max Pacioretty is good, even in a bad season, for 20 goals. There is just no depth up front on the defense without Shea Weber. They don't even have a number due to two defensemen. Jeff Petrie was okay last year. You look at Alzner, Ben, Mete, Ouellette, David Schlemko, Mike Riley. Those are some of their defensemen, and it does not get much better at the forward position. No. And the draft, even this year, they passed on Zadina and took Kotkaniemi.
Wow. Yeah.
So that's
a lot of questions
a lot
up
of
there.
Question marks. Where do you go? And you have to rebuild and try and go and get a lot for Pacioretty, because he's done in a Montreal Canadian uniform. But Montreal has got some tough years ahead of him, and it's going to be tough in this coming season. Marc Bergevin under the microscope in Montreal.
I got to say, I'm a little surprised with the Pacioretty news, only because he led the team in scoring for six straight years until last season, and he still had an okay season. It was down, but it was a down year for everybody with the Habs, right? So I'm a little surprised by this news.
It is, and where's the goal scoring going to come from? And it's not a big group. Paul Byron, you got Froese, Gallagher's going to be there. There just doesn't look to be a lot in the cupboard.
Right, where's the scoring going to come
from? And it doesn't look like the prospects are going to be there immediately. Mm-hmm. If you drafted Zadina, there's a kid that can maybe come in and play right away. They passed on that in the draft. So the rebuild has to take shape in some form. The owner there, Molson, has to be on board with it, and they're going to have to find a way to retool on the fly. But the rebuild word in Montreal is blasphemy.
Yes.
It doesn't like to be said there. They just like to say they're trying to mix it around and tool it around. But Montreal, it's rebuilding.
Yeah, so before all of you Habs fans turn the channel as quickly as possible, let's look at who they did add and who is subtracted. And we're not including Pacioretty on this because so far he's still with the Habs. But Joel Armia, Max Domi, Xavier Ouellette, Plekanec coming back to Montreal, and Matthew Pekka as well. So you mentioned Galchenyuk. That's kind of a big name that they will not have anymore this season. So, it's kind of hard to figure out what this season will look like for Montreal. And again, with the Shea Weber news, he's out after knee surgery until at least mid-December. What does that do to this team?
Shea Weber's the quarterback on the power play. There's no one to run the defense on the power play. You got Drouin, who'll probably play the point position, but that's a problem source. I don't think that power play is going to be very effective in any way, shape, or fashion. Shea Weber was a guy with a heavy bomb, and he could play some strong, solid minutes defensively. He eats up 22, 23 minutes a game, and that's a luxury as a coach when you can have a top guy out there to play against the other team's top lines. Shea Weber, good facets in all areas, and that's a guy that you just can't miss when you're that inexperienced and have that kind of depth on defense. Look at the names. Juleson, where do you go? Petrie had a good year last year, and that's where it really ends.
Yeah, Mike Riley, very much.
How do you move the puck? In this game, it's all about the puck movement.
Yeah.
You got to move the puck and distribute it and get it up there. Even if you did have really good puck-moving defensemen, if you got it up to the forwards, I'm not sure they could do much more else with it. Carey Price, the goaltender, good luck.
Big question for him as well. Let's take a look at the forward lines as well, because there is a little bit of movement there. And let's be honest, Max Domi could be good. Maybe once we see him out of Arizona, maybe this will be just what he needs to really thrive up there. We know he's excited to be there, but there are a lot of questions here.
Well, Jonathan Drouin's got to, if he's going to do it, this is his time. He's got to be a force and show that he can do it throughout 82 games. That has never happened, and he's got a lot of defensive question marks around him. Max Domi seems to be excited to be in Montreal. He plays with an edge, fast. Don't mind him being there, but that's just not a very big group at all. They got six forwards under 6 foot tall in structure, but Domi plays much bigger game than that. And a player that wants to be there, so hopefully he can provide a leadership role. But when you're looking at Max Domi, maybe to be one of your leading guys and leading goal scorers, that's a stretch for Montreal.
He had to be a leader in Arizona because everyone's young there, right? So, yeah, you're right. He had some leadership qualities there, but we will see what happens.
There's no patience in Montreal. There's a little patience
in Arizona. Pressure cooker, yes, exactly.
The media, it could be interesting.
Okay.